During the pass-out ceremony, President Museveni emphasized the need to establish training schools like Olilim Centers of Excellence, saying that they help to give exposure to the trainees, and in turn they are able to learn and develop themselves.
I also want to congratulate the Ugandans because you are really moving in terms of building institutions. You heard that these young people are 4,212. Now, all of them, except three, have got at least O-level certificate. Only three were from primary living, and 500 of them are graduates. So don't scatter resources and fail to show our people what excellence means.
On the issue of insecurity in the Teso sub-region, the president was happy to note that the government has got the situation under control.
On the issue of the insecurity that was going on here, they were eye-banging the enemy. These are nothing. They are very easy to deal with. So they would tire soldiers, following the soldiers, these people on foot, just wasting soldiers' time. And yet there are so much capacity in the system which they were not using. You can even, indisciplined caterpillars were even going and staying in the wilderness, in the bush.
President Museveni disclosed that the government was also dealing with the issue of Pokot and Turkanas, who come from Kenya and disturb Ugandans.
So I had a meeting in Barilegi with all these people, and I said, please stop eye-banging these people. Because they were just wasting soldiers' time by not using this capacity, that capacity there, they don't use it, they just use Fatanyayo. That issue is finished.
At the ceremony, President Museveni awarded the best students from the training course. The Vice President, Her Excellency retired Major Jessica Lupo Epel, commended President Museveni for professionalizing the UPDF and other armed forces, an endeavor she said has resulted into total stability of Uganda from north to south and east to west.
On the matter of cattle theft by our uncles, I would like to say, for today, thank you very much for the quietness which is currently prevailing right inside Karamoja itself, but also in all neighboring areas.
The Minister of Defense and Veteran Affairs, Honorable Vincent Bamlangakyi Sempijja, lauded President Museveni for his enduring commitment that has enabled Uganda to build a strong and reliable army that can guarantee the security of Ugandans. He told the trainees that the skills they have acquired from the training should make them comfortable to serve with vigor and valor in whatever theater they are deployed.
Of the Minister of Defense and Veteran Affairs and the Uganda People's Defense Forces Fraternity, allow me, Your Excellency, to welcome you and thank you very much for finding time from your very busy schedule to come and officiate at this pass-out ceremony of 4,212 trainees.
It is a service to our people, and a service that demands sacrifice at all times. Remove anything called job in whatever you have started today. Because there is nobody who can pay for your life. Nobody in this world can pay for your life. You have decided to give your lives for the people of Uganda.
The commandant of Olilim Training School, Lieutenant Colonel Leria Mugasa, reported to the president that the trainees of basic military training for local defense unit costs intake of September 2022 to 2023 began their training on 17th of August 2022 with a total of 4,303. Among them, 697 were female, but as the course progressed, 91 trainees dropped out from the training due to various reasons.
It's my honor and gratitude to present to you 4,212 young, well-trained and disciplined Ugandans who have attended and successfully completed 58 weeks of basic military training, ready for pass out.
The pass out ceremony was also attended by the ministers, members of parliament, UPDF leadership, among others.